सर्व सद्गुण संपन्ना गीता भक्ति परायणा भवितुं जीवनेस्माकं जागृता बालका वयम् उत्थाने राष्ट्रधर्मस्य विज्ञान दृष्टिमाशिता विवेकानंद मार्गेण वयं सर्वे समर्पिताः।
Supposed to come tomorrow, isn't it?
I wanted to give you a surprise.
God bless you. By the way, if you have bent little more, it would have been better for you.
What do you mean, uncle?
Come, I will explain. Sit down.
So tell me.
Look, my child. Touching our elders' feet is in our culture. But it also has a scientific reason behind it. First reason is when you bend forward, your head's blood circulation increases. And second is, human being has all his energy concentrated at his feet.
Our culture means shape of our values and ethics. But if we look closely, then our cultural values and ethics is connected to many scientific facts and reasoning. According to Newton's law, objects are bound by the gravitational law, and gravitational mass is always towards attracting forces. Same way, this law is applied to our bodies too. Our head is the North Pole and feet is considered South Pole. Magnetic energies always move from North Pole to South Pole. That's why our body's North Pole means our head, a positive energy enters and goes to the South Pole means our feet. And in our feet, this energy deposits in large amount and our feet becomes the energy point. And whenever someone touches our feet, all our positive energy enters in that person's body. That is why they say that we should always touch the feet for elders' blessings.
But uncle, where are auntie and Didi?
Your auntie has gone to Haridwar and Priya must be somewhere here only. Priya, look who's come here.
Hey, weren't you supposed to come tomorrow? I came one day before to see this reaction. You are so naughty. Okay, tell me, how are you these days? I'm doing great. You tell me, how are you? I'm perfectly fine. Why don't you both sit? I'll get something to eat.
Okay, get it. Hey, what happened?
Huh?
What are you looking at so keenly?
I was just thinking, why don't you get these tiles replaced?
Tiles? My child, this is coated with cow dung. This is our antiseptic.
Come on, please don't make fun of me, uncle.
No, my child, I am serious. Listen, Cow dung is not only bacteria free but also kills harmful bacteria in your tiles. If one day you will not mop it, then thousands of bacteria will grow on it. Whereas this cow dung coated flooring works as an insulator the whole day. In the summer season, it absorbs the heat, and in the winter season, it maintains the room temperature. So now tell me, are you really feeling hot in here? No, right? Whereas in the hostel room, you can't even stay for a minute without the AC.
I'm not feeling hot in here, but...
Not just that. Nuclear radiations can also be blocked by this. In a few hospitals in South Europe's nation, patient room cleaning is done by cow dung ashes. So now tell me, how can I leave such a profitable thing?
True. Come on, enough of your chatting now. Let him eat something first. He must be really tired.
Start. Have a glass of milk. And drink cow milk every day. You will never ever feel tired.
Okay, uncle.
Slowly. Take this. You had your breakfast?
Yes. Yes, uncle. By the way, uncle, What is going on there?
Where?
There. That side.
Okay, there. There they are doing processing of cow dung and cow urine, through which they will make medicines for the villagers.
So, tell me, uncle, where is the gobar gas plant?
See there? Can you see it?
Oh, yes, I can see it.
That is the one. 1 minute. Can you please hold this?
Here, take it.
Yes, Ram Babu. Okay. Very good. So you are in Banaras for emotion of your mother's ashes. You told your son about it. Okay, when he comes, I will give him the medicines. What happened? I'm sure you want to ask me something. Tell me, what is it?
Actually, uncle, everyone says keep Ganga clean. But if we all immerse ashes of dead bodies in it, then it will be dirtier, right?
No, my child. In fact, with this, the Ganga water becomes cleaner. See, as per science, in the Ganga river water, there is presence of mercury, because of which bones, calcium and phosphorus gets mixed in water, right? And because of which, the organisms which survive in this water get their nourishment. Bones also have sulfur. So sulfur and mercury together form mercury sulfide salt, because of which water's harmful bacteria is killed. And with the remaining bone calcium, water stays clean.
Is that true, uncle? But how do you know all this?
By reading. Come, let's go.
Okay.
Priya, how much more time will it take?
It's ready, Dad.
My son, do you want to sit with us or do you want to sit on the dining table?
I'll sit with you, uncle.
Very good. Come.
We should always sit on the floor to have food. But why is it so? When we sit in the Sukhasan position, stomach sends messages to the brain to secrete digestive enzymes for good digestion. So the digestion happens quickly. And how do you know all this, Didi? This is what Dad told me. Is that right, uncle?
Son, I don't talk while eating food. And if your sister is saying it, means it is correct. Eat your food. Oh wow, you have woken up early.
Yes.
Very good.
So you get up early in the morning. So do you offer water to the sun in the morning?
Yes, sometimes.
Very good. So do you know the importance of offering water to the sun?
Yes, you had told me that while offering water to the sun, the water stream mixes with the sun rays and makes 7 color spectrums, which our body absorbs and the defect of our bodies gets rectified. And not only that, even our eyes and brain functions better. We also get the required vitamin D for our skin and bones from the sun.
Well done. Very good. Our sun is the source of energy of this world. And to know about its power, it is very important for us. Now you take your bath. We have to go to the temple.
Okay.
See, I'm not forcing you, my son. If you want to come, then only come.
No, uncle. I really want to come.
Very good. So go fast and take bath and come.
Okay. What is this, uncle? Why is there so much smoke over here and you seem to be so relaxed? Are you not feeling suffocated?
No. And you will also not feel. Your sister is doing havan. And do you know? When you burn dried cow dung with cow ghee, then it makes oxygen automatically. And you get suffocated when there is no oxygen. Am I right? And yes, I just remembered something. Sit. I will tell you one important thing.
3rd December 1984, when in Bhopal Union Carbide Factory, due to leaked poisonous isocyanide gas, lakhs of people lost their life in radius of 1 to 2 kilometers of this factory. At that time, in that radius, there were two families didn't get affected at all. Everyone was entirely safe. After investigation and research, came to know that both families used to do havan with cow dung and cow ghee every morning. That's why that night the havan smoke worked as an antidote for these two families and they were saved from the poisonous gas.
Tell me one thing. What were you working as, uncle?
Regular job.
But auntie told me that you were a master in school.
Yes.
Then definitely you must be teaching science. That's why you're so knowledgeable. Tell me one thing, uncle. There definitely would be a scientific reason behind ringing the bell also. Even after ringing it so many times, why do we like the sound so much?
The shape of the bells is somewhat like that. So that when it is rung by us, a very special kind of echo sound is created, which produces powerful waves in our surrounding, which actually affects our brain directly. And you know, my son, between our right and left hemispheres of the brain, a coordination is created, due to which our concentration increases.
And you can even feel it.
Now let's take God's blessings.
Om Namah Shivaya. Jai Bhole Shankar.
Where are you going? Wait for some time. If you have some wish, then ask from Bholenath ji. Look, this is a holy place. When you ask for a wish at this place, the positivity around here sends your words quickly to the entire universe. And words said in this positive environment affect really faster. And our wish quickly comes true. My son, same logic applies for our mantra. Our mantras are very powerful. Our mantras create a positive environment around us, just like around this temple. That's why healing therapy conducted by chanting mantras is given lot of importance abroad. But we ourselves can't recognize it. Come, let's pray for everyone's well-being. Jai Bholenath.
Jai Bholenath.
Please bless everyone with happiness. Let's go. What? Aren't you thinking that why do we apply tilak?
Yes.
See, in the center of our forehead, there is an Agya Chakra. Here three main nerves, Idha, Pingala and Sushumna meet. Because it's a conscious center, our whole body is controlled through here. When we apply tilak, especially if it's of sandal, then our mind always stays cool and calm. And serotonin and beta endorphin, these two enzymes are created, because of which our memory power becomes strong.
Wow! I'll start applying tilak from today itself.
Come on, breakfast must be ready.
Okay. Uncle, 1 minute. We worship the tulsi and we walk around it every day because it increases our immunity, and tulsi is useful in a lot of Ayurvedic medicines. You had mentioned this. And since then, I've been eating 2-3 leaves every day.
Very good. Well done. And yes, there are many scientific reasons behind it. The essential oil which we get in tulsi plant makes our respiratory system stronger. And second thing is, tulsi is a good antioxidant, which absorbs carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide and sulfur dioxide, which are harmful gases for humans. Now such a worthy plant should be surely worshipped.
You are right.
Now you go home, I'll join you in some time.
Uncle, one more thing. I want to see those old albums.
Okay, I'll show you when I'm back.
No, please uncle. I know you will forget it. Do one thing. You tell me where you have kept it. I'll find it.
Okay, fine. It must be in the cupboard or in the suitcase. Okay?
Okay.
What happened?
You had told me you're a master in school.
You told me that.
But you had even agreed to it that day.
Yes, but now I'm still saying yes.
But this file says something else, uncle.
Please don't tell this to your auntie.
But why?
Look, son. I get a lot of happiness when your auntie thinks that I'm a teacher at a school. Do you know? When we two got married at that time, your auntie was not very educated. And for her, being a schoolmaster means a bigger position. Somebody told her that I am a master. So she asked me, so I also said yes. And I was surely a master.
But you were a master in science and assistant scientist in Indian Research Department.
Your auntie does not understand all this.
So this means this truth was only known by you and Dad, and you must have told Dad not to tell her, right, Uncle? Then what are you doing here, Uncle? You should be in a city. You can do so many things there.
I can do that here also, and maybe doing it also. Look, son, in the city there are many people like me, but there is no one here. This is the right place for me. By staying here in village, I'm learning the science of our culture in different new ways.
Uncle, when I grow up, I want to be a great man like you.
Stay happy. God bless. God bless. All the best.
Indian culture is based on scientific culture. Its rituals and traditions have science in it. Foreign scientists have done research on it. They have analyzed and understood this and brought it to daily use. And we Indians, we are getting attracted towards Western culture, which is hollow from inside. All this is happening because we are not seeing the hidden signs in our culture. We call our traditional ways to be old-fashioned, and we are just going away from it. Nowadays on Diwali, we light China's bulb instead of ghee diyas, because we don't know the importance of ghee diyas. I am not asking you to follow Indian culture. I am asking you to understand it. First you understand it and then follow it. I am sure then you will be proud of your traditional culture.